I can't remember most of my childhood.
Oh.
Okay.
I love the relatable content.
Yeah, I mean, same. I mean, okay. What's up, guys? I'm Teala Dunn, and welcome back to another episode of Anonymously Yours. If you're new here, every single week I'm joined with an incredible guest, and we react to the juiciest, craziest stories that are sent in by you guys anonymously. Of course, we will not be exposing anybody. And if you guys want to join on the fun and share your stories, whether it's your friend's stories, your cousin's stories, whoever stories you want, it will not be exposed, okay? We will not be exposing your identity. And you can submit your stories in the show card, so make sure you guys do that. But without further ado, I want to introduce you guys to my incredible friend, Auli'i.
Hello.
Welcome. You are so, you're such an angelic person.
That's terrifying.
No, it's incredible. Like, Auli'i just has this incredible warm presence. Like, when I'm around her, I just feel like I just have like a big hug. Like, aww, you're just like a, you're like a warm blanket.
Well, I enjoy spending time with you, so that's probably why. For the people who I don't enjoy spending time around, I'm not this person.
You're like, no. So for people that don't know, let's give a little backstory on how we met.
So we met on Hulu's Crush. Yes. We were both filming. I played AJ. You played Stacy. And yeah, we bonded on that shoot.
Yes, we did. So we filmed that movie in Syracuse, New York, literally last summer. It was so hot. It was so humid. No shade to Syracuse, New York, but also shade. Just like the middle of nowhere, honestly. Like just the middle of nowhere. But we made the most of it. And I feel like in a situation like that, when you're filming, you know, somewhere you're not used to, you tend to get a lot closer to who you work with than if you were to be filming in LA or like New York or like a major city. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like New York City, not New York, Syracuse. But yeah, you were sweet off the bat, so genuine. And I don't know, we spent a lot of time together. And she was so cute. Just always like, she would always be reading her little books and just like, she's just the best, honestly.
Keep describing me as angelic. I like
angelic.
That.
She's angelic.
I love it.
Oh my God. Okay. Can I, I'm going to do a little story time. Okay. So one of my favorite memories, and Auli'i is probably going to be like, oh God, like don't. But one of my favorite memories with Auli'i while filming Crush, we were filming. Basically we were so tired. We've been doing so many night shoots, like back to back night shoots. And we were all in the hotel just hanging out. And Tyler and I were just like so annoying. I think we had like an energy drink or something. And we were like, Auli'i, can you please do it? Can you please do it? And she's like, do what? And we were like, can you please sing the song? Like, please.
Oh my God.
Please. And she's like, oh, I guess. And she did it for us. And when I tell you, not to just keep stroking your ego right now, I got chills. Just full body chills. It was the most incredible like experience ever.
Not
that like I didn't know. Of course, obviously I know you're freaking Moana. For those that don't know, she's Moana.
We're talking about How Far I'll Go.
Yes.
We're also talking about 11 p.m. in a hotel.
Yeah. And they're like, if not later, it might have been 1 a.m.
This isn't like a sweet humming lullaby. No. This is a full song. You know, this is at the end of our day and they're like, please perform.
Please. And I'm Tyler like, and I were begging. She's like,
I stood up for that last note.
She had to. No, literally, she utilized the entire kitchen. I think we were in Bella's room. Yeah. She utilized the entire kitchen and just made it her stage. And Tyler and I were like, oh my God. Has to be one of my favorite memories of you. Because you were like, guys, really? But then you really just did it for us. You really gave it your all.
I commit.
You
to the
commit
bit.
All or nothing. 100% or I don't want it.
Thank you.
Period.
Thank you. Auli'i. Please don't ask me to do that on the podcast.
Oh, no. Don't worry. There won't be any of that. That was just for us only, okay? Anyways, Auli'i, I have to ask you. What is the craziest experience or story that you can share with the audience that a lot of people don't know?
My craziest experience, I've never even told you this, I don't think, is I was dating a boy. Oh. And I still lived with my mom. He still lived with his parents. And, like, he was very far from me. He probably had an hour and a half commute.
Oh, wow.
And that was no traffic.
Ooh.
So when we would see each other, we would spend a lot of time in the car. And so we were kissing.
Oh.
In the backseat of the car.
Oh, I bet the windows were fogging up.
Just kissing.
Okay.
And we've been in there for a little bit, and then we see these lights start coming up, and they're red and blue. And
oh no, not the lights you want.
No, and basically we, like, an officer knocked on the window, and my boyfriend at the time walked out, and he was like, "Yo," and the officer's just like, "What you doing?" My boyfriend's like,
"Chilling,
you know," and he said, "You know, I will never forget the little shrug, the little shrug." And it was, everything was fine, but because they didn't have anything to, like, charge us with, they were like, "Well, we heard you were littering." And when we were driving back to, like, he was driving me home, I was like, "Littering? Littering?
Where'd you get that from?
That is offensive."
Yeah, it,
like,
really
I
is.
Might have been hooking up in the back of the car, yeah, but I do not litter.
No.
Yeah, that was a crazy story. I remember being like,
"You're like, hi." No, but don't ask, don't tell. That's crazy. Not him thinking you were littering. Rude officer. She would never.
I would never.
No.
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 But that was the craziest thing.
That is crazy. That's so cute, though. That's a little, like, teen little moment. Butterflies in the stomach. You know. You know how it is. Now, Auli'i, are you ready for the tea that we have coming up?
I'm just
going to read you the list before we actually dive deep into it.
Okay.
So, coming up, we have... Number one, I wrote a bad review for my coworker and got her fired. Oh. Damn. Oh. That's shady. That's shady. Number two, I can't remember most of my childhood.
Oh.
Okay.
I love the relatable content.
Yeah, I mean, same. I mean, okay.
Yeah.
Number three, my friends didn't get me anything for my birthday.
That's
T. T. Okay. Number four, her husband was a cheater and I let her know. As you should.
Whoa.
As you should.
There might be ramifications that come with that, though.
I know. Because what if she doesn't believe the friend? Then they... It's a lot of issues. So let's just start with story number one, shall we?
Okay, story time.
Story time. If you're listening, if you're watching, grab a snack, get some popcorn, grab your tea, because you're in for a treat. I haven't even read this, so we're just going to react together, okay?
Okay.
Number one, I wrote a bad review for my coworker and got her fired. Last year, I worked at a movie theater and I really loved my job. It started off as a job I would do in the summers, and then I moved home to do college online, and I thought I could go back and work there again for some extra cash. As you should, get your coin.
Yeah.
Sounds smart. You know, movie theater, we love the popcorn.
Smart. Get a summer job.
That was another thing we did in Syracuse. We saw a lot of movies.
Yeah, we did.
We saw a lot of movies. Anyways, and we went to the fair. Anyways. Moving on. I'm getting lost. When I came back, it was awesome. All my coworkers were great, and we really were like a family. We hung out outside of work and all had a very strong bond. Then we hired a group of new people. Turns out one of them was this girl who used to bully me in high school.
Oh no.
See, she didn't tell me that. That changes a lot. She was always so awful to me and mean. And when she started, she even had the audacity to act like she was meeting me for the first time.
Well, I mean, maybe water under the bridge.
That's bold, though. To be like,
the very first time.
I'm such and such. Like,
oh.
Wow. The audacity. Anyways.
Gemini.
It's giving Gemini energy. Okay. It was so uncomfortable to work with her. She hadn't changed at all. She was always really snooty and clicky. Ugh. She basically started planning hangouts with my coworkers, who were my friends first, and purposely not inviting me. Wow. When I approached one of my coworkers about it, they said she told them not to invite me. Eventually, she told them that I was bullying her. She was so heartless. So one day, I had enough. And I made a fake email and a fake Google review account. I wrote a sketchy review about the bad customer service at the movie theater and called her out by her full name, saying that she was rude and didn't deliver good customer service. I went into work a few days later, and we had a whole talk with our manager about being kind and patient with customers, and we're told that somebody had been fired due to the poor customer service review. They never said who it was, but I never saw her there again. Oh my God.
First of all, the importance of a good education means that in today's day and age, you can create a fake email account and send a well-written email review pretending to be another person, and you get shit done yourself. And I think that I don't know if this person is male or female, but I will say that I respect it.
I do too, especially because this girl was a bully. Like, I just thought this was a coworker that was annoying. This girl was a bully. And the fact that she's going, like, purposely not inviting her, trying to be friends with her friends, no.
Right.
No, like, you don't need that energy in the workspace.
No, we've talked about this before. Like, you don't have to be friends with all the people
you work with.
You work with.
No.
But you...
You have to have respect, though.
Yes, and do not be malicious.
No.
Or...
No.
Or, like, purposely leaving someone out. Like, that's high school stuff.
Yeah, it is. You know? It really is. And the fact that they're in college now, like, girl, like... She's acting like a middle school student is what she's acting like. So I'm not mad at this girl for doing that. Because I think, like, your energy in your work environment is so important. It really does make or break. And, like, at the end of the day, exactly what Auli'i said, you don't have to be friends with everybody you work with. Obviously, you're not going to be best friends with every person you work with. But you have to have respect for one another.
I'm not saying and that you should girl, get everyone fired, but...
Yeah.
But if you can.
But if you can. Kidding. If the shoe fits. If the shoe fits.
That's the only option.
You take matters into your own computer typing.
I mean, at the end of the day, like, if you can't if you can't take what you're dishing out, don't dish it out.
That's true.
You know what I mean? It seems like this was the first time this girl kind of stepped up to her, and she, like, can't take it. So why are you being rude?
You have to deal with the consequences. Also, if you are being unkind, like, at the workplace, it's also probably suffering in some other areas.
I agree.
Yeah.
I think whether or not, like, it was just her. I think this girl has really bad energy, and she probably would just be a bad apple for the group in general.
Yes.
So, bye. I hope you learned your lesson, gal, whoever you are. Rude. Okay. Time for story number two. Are you ready?
Do it.
Let's go. I can't remember most of my childhood. I am used to having trouble remembering things, but recently I've been wondering about what my childhood was really like. Mm-hmm. It's not like I can't recall anything at all, but I draw up blank most times, and I hate to admit it. When my mom or someone who's known me for years tells me stuff that happened years ago, I usually can't recall anything.
Wow.
Whoa. I can't remember what I was taught in high school, for the most part, or things that happened not too long ago.
Wow.
She's sounding like Dory right now. Like, girl, what's going on? I'm kind of concerned now. It reminds me of the Dory TikTok. Let's go. Anyways, I love Dory. Okay, that's like such a good movie. Anyways.
No, you're not shading Dory. You're shading her. Don't apologize to Dory.
I'm sorry if you're watching this. I love you. No judgment, but kind of concerned.
Yeah.
But Dory's a great character. So anywho, moving right along. I can't remember 95% of my elementary school life or life before that. Kindergarten, being a toddler, absolutely nothing. It seems like most kids remember a few things, at least from that time of their life, or remember meeting new friends in elementary school and people that they've seen since. But I don't have any of those memories. I can't remember certain things, events, incidents from college, and I only graduated in 2017. And more recently, I find that there are things that I can't remember until somebody brings it up at work. I ask myself, is something wrong with me? Am I blocking out memories, or do I have some kind of mental illness that is affecting my memory? I recently discovered that ADHD people struggle to remember things and are easily distracted, but I haven't looked that much into it. Plus, I think finding distractions and procrastination are kind of common. I worry that if no one tells me things, I'll forget them forever. And I'm still quite young to be having problems with my memory. Sometimes I also forget to do certain tasks. I've come to terms with my forgetful memory, so I never wondered about it until recently. I can't even recall if I've always been forgetful or if it's been worsening over the years. And I never realized.
How would you know? How would you remember that? How do you remember what you forget?
How do you remember what you forget? I mean, that's really scary.
Yeah. It must be really disorienting.
Young.
Yeah.
She's definitely like in her early 20s.
Yeah.
So.
Is that the end of the story?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
It. Well, I hope you remembered that you sent this in. But I don't know. I think, I don't know. I mean, a lot of people, or I actually don't personally know anybody that has short-term memory loss, but I know it's a thing. Like.
Yeah. I think, well. What do I remember from being like a toddler, from a youngin'? I remember almost being like drowned in a pool. Like,
no.
But like, I only remember like, it was someone jump. It was like a little kid jumping on my back, and I was also a little kid. But when I think back, like, I also don't remember a lot of things, but I remember big moments or big emotions.
Me too.
So, but then I also, like, I would fear for that person because that's also a really easy place to get manipulated or gaslit.
Very you true. Don't know. Especially in relationships. Like, somebody could be like, remember when you said this or you promised me this?
Right.
And you could be thinking like, oh my God, I did, but I don't remember. Like, people could easily take advantage of that.
Yeah, because, I mean, we were hearing about her mom and stuff like that. And that, like, that's... I mean, not that all moms do that, but like there's potential to the truth being skewed.
Yeah.
I don't know what like a solution would be for that besides like,
I don't either. Like, I mean, what, how do you like fix that?
Maybe submit it to someone other than a podcast.
Yes. Love I you the most, but maybe,
maybe a healthcare professional.
Yeah.
Would be
a doctor,
cause
a therapist.
See all of the above.
All of the above. Psychiatrists, I don't know.
But very good that you were able to share that.
Yeah. Yes, absolutely. And I mean, there is a lot of things from my childhood that I don't remember, but then there's so much that I do remember, like,
right.
You know what I mean?
High school and college.
Yeah,
or like that, like this whole age, like you should still be able to
remember that.
And you should be able to like found like really good memories. Cause that would also be disorienting of like a sense of self. Cause your memories make up your personality.
Exactly. And like who you meet along the way is like, it shapes you as a person too. And if you forget everybody that you were friends with, it's like, oh no.
Journaling, maybe.
Yeah, maybe. Yes.
Yeah.
That's a really good suggestion. I think you should journal down your life.
Yeah.
You do have a little diary and then you can read it back and really reflect. And maybe that'll help you, you know, memorize things.
Or
again.
even like our social media is like, that's initially what it was supposed to be for, right? Is
sharing memories, documenting things.
And at least you'll have like a timeline of when things happen and when people interacted.
Yeah.
I don't know. Like, you don't have to, I guess, let your brain carry all that weight. Like, write it down, find other ways to supplement.
I agree. Also, a cool suggestion could be like, vlogging on your phone just for yourself, like on your camera roll, if you're doing something fun, if you're going on vacation, if you're hanging out with your friends, like just document those memories just for yourself. If you do social media, why not post it? But if you're a private person, just to have, and then you can reflect it in case you're like, oh, last week, what did I do? You could just watch it.
Yeah. And then you can have your own made at home Blair Witch Project as well. Aha! Look at that. You can monetize
that.
Everything. Everything is content.
Look at that. Everything is content. That's actually, I feel like we gave kind of decent suggestion.
I know, we actually like really killed
that.
We
kind of crushed that.
We
crushed that. Okay, guys, watch Crush. Anyways. Okay, now it is time for story number 3. Here we go. My friends didn't get me anything for my birthday.
Story ends there. Awful.
Awful.
Drop them.
Awful.
Sorry,
awful.
Keep going.
I will say, I'm not a big materialistic person, but like I don't like need a big gift from any friend at all. But I think it's important that I think thoughtful gifts are the best thing. Yeah. Like somebody's favorite flower or their favorite type of drink or like their favorite coffee shop, something like that.
Yeah.
I think you have like, if that's your best friend, come on now.
I'm intrigued too.
Among my friend group, birthdays are treated like huge events. I always thought birthday gifts were kind of transactional. If I get you a gift for your birthday, I expect one in return. Is that bad? In the past, all four of my best friends busted the bank, spending at least $100 in each gift. Oh, okay. For one of my friends, we rented a hotel room for the entire weekend. Whoa.
Wow.
And again, all of us spent a lot of money. Mm. But I haven't gotten a birthday party since I was maybe 13 or 12 or 13. From my friends. So I was kind of thinking my friends might plan something for me like they had for everyone else. Today, my birthday rolled around and nothing. I got a few texts from everyone wishing me a happy birthday and a couple questions asking how my birthday was going. I can't tell if I'm overreacting or if I just have some shitty friends. I don't really know how to make friends as an adult, as it's so much harder than it was as a kid. Wow. Honestly, I think... maybe you're not as close to this friend group as you think you are. Because if your friends are renting hotels and doing the most, like not even doing a birthday dinner, they're doing a birthday weekend for the friend group. They're probably buying drinks for their friend, going out on the town, dinners, Ubers. Clearly, they give a crap about some of the people in the friend group. For them to just wish you a text, not even plan to see you, not even plan anything beyond the gift.
Right.
You could have planned a lunch. You could have, let me take you out to dinner. Grab coffee. Let's go on a hike. Something. They're just going to send you a text?
Yeah.
I don't think that's like a close friend at all.
Well, it's also, I've never had like a friend or friend group plan me a birthday party. Mm-hmm. So like I always expect to be part of the planning process. So
yeah.
There's also maybe a little bit of accountability too of maybe you should voice that you would really appreciate hanging out with that set of friends.
Exactly.
Because also if,
it depends on the dynamic too. Like, does this girl have a boyfriend and were the friends like, oh, you know, she'll probably want to spend her birthday with her boyfriend, or I don't know. But then again, that doesn't make sense either, because it's your birthday. When you, even if you were dating somebody, wouldn't you want like all of your friends to be a part of that? I don't know.
I feel like this was a short story and we need more context.
I agree. I have many questions, but my gut is telling me that I don't think this friend group is as close as you think.
Yes. Yes.
They might just be like a fun group of people that you go to parties with. I don't think they're like your ride or dies. This does not sound like a squad.
No, but also if this is your only group of friends, then you need to
get new friends.
You really, like, I know it's so, it is so hard.
It really is. Meet new people and to just,
where are you supposed to do that?
Yeah.
Where do you meet new friends? Usually, or like if you have, I don't
Bumble
know.
Bumble BFF? I've never used it, but I hear it's great.
What is that?
It's like, it's, you know how Bumble's like the dating app?
Oh.
But they have it for friends. It's called Bumble BFF. Really? To meet, like, friends, yeah. When,
okay.
When people move to new towns, a lot of people use it. Some of my friends have used it. And
there's an app for that.
Yeah, there's an app for that. So worst comes worst. But I would suggest make me.
Yeah. Yeah. Cause maybe, cause honestly, also maybe it's not you. Maybe it's them. Like, maybe it's the fact that they like are just not the right fit for you and you deserve better.
I agree. Yeah, I think on to the next.
Yeah. Deserve people who celebrate you, especially on your birthday, but also every other day.
Every other day, but especially on that day.
Yeah. That's messed
up. I mean, there's no excuse on that day.
No, that's messed up.
That's just...
I'm so sorry.
I'm so sorry. Happy birthday. Anyways, Auli'i, it is time...
Gimme.
...for you read story number 4.
Okay.
Okay, here we go.
Oh, Lord.
I'm nervous. What is this?
Her husband was a cheater and I let her know. I met a guy online on a dating app. He seemed to be really nice. He was attractive and intelligent. He was great at holding up his end of the conversation. Ooh. I asked him what he did for a living, and he told me he was a college professor in a computer programming department.
That sounds amazing.
Yeah.
That, to me, I would be like, oh, attractive.
I know.
Wow. Okay, smart.
I wanted to make sure he was legit smart, so I asked if he had a Facebook.
Okay. There it is.
He told me he did not because he disliked social media and worked with computers all day and wanting nothing to do with anything similar after hours.
Okay.
I didn't think much of it because I know many people who aren't on Facebook for similar reasons. Mm-hmm. Also, Facebook is so old. Why didn't you ask
if you have an Instagram? Why is your first thing Facebook?
Okay. Ask for his LinkedIn then. Other people aren't on Facebook for similar reasons, but I did look him up on the school's website and he was telling the truth.
Oh, okay.
Because he was a college professor. Right. Sorry, I have to connect the dots. He did indeed work there. After chatting online for a while, I finally felt comfortable enough giving him my phone number. We called and texted and finally met for dinner. After a series of dates, I invited him back to my place.
Oh.
But he never wanted to invite me to his place. His first excuse was he had two dogs that hated new people. Train your dogs
or you could put them like outside.
That's terrible. That's really bad. People need to train their dogs. The second excuse was his place was messy because he had no time to clean up after himself. Things weren't adding up, so I did a lot of digging. I went to the school's Facebook page and found some photos of an event that took place in his department. A coworker of his was tagged. I went to her page, and it was open to the public.
Okay.
I searched through her posts, and there was one from a baby shower. The photo caption said, "Can't wait for the baby to get here."
Stop.
And there were people tagged in the photo. I went through them, and someone with his last name was tagged in it. It was his wife.
Oh my God.
And the shower was for her. She was currently pregnant.
Are you kidding me?
I
get the ick.
There's like two more paragraphs. Oh my God, we're not even done. I thought about what to do with this information. At first, I thought about not doing anything with it and telling him he was a cheater and block him and move on.
Yes.
But as a woman, I would want to know if my husband was cheating on me. So I messaged her. I showed her all of the screenshots. I showed her all the times he called me and texts of him asking to come over and even sending me photos. She responded, I'm just lost for words right now, thank you. I blocked him from contacting me and kept a check on her page, and about a week later her marital status changed from married to separated. I still in a way feel guilty for telling her, especially her being pregnant.
Oh my goodness. First of all, we have so much to unpack, but I just want to say I love the girl that sent this in, because she went directly to the woman.
Yeah.
She was respectful. And honestly, if she would have never came out with that, this woman would still be married to this man. And he would be doing the same thing.
Yeah.
Like, whether or not, obviously, this woman's going to cut it off with him because he's a piece of crap. Like, crap.
Yeah.
Trash.
Yeah.
But beyond that, he's going to do the same thing.
I know.
And he would just continue it.
Yeah.
So, and then this woman's pregnant.
I know.
So get out now. You know what I mean?
That's very true. Like I think of, I'm like, oh my God, this is horrible. Like, I'm cringing on the inside, but it's just a delayed explosion, if anything, because
it would happen regardless.
I mean, you can't change a person.
No.
How horrible.
What a piece of shit.
Mm.
Like, I'm sorry. I have no respect for you. First of all, cheating in general, disgusting. If you feel like you want to cheat, or if you have a wandering eye, get into an open relationship if y'all are comfortable with that, or literally just be single. It's not that hard.
Yeah.
But beyond that, you literally are married. This isn't even boyfriend, girlfriend. You're married.
Goodness.
You have a baby on the way. Like, you're just a disgrace to humanity. Like, what are you doing?
You're a disgrace to humanity.
You're a disgrace. Like, this poor baby. This poor baby.
I know.
I just, wow.
But if we bring it back to this wonderful, I mean, I'm going to call you a wonderful woman, because if it takes a lot also to accumulate the screenshots and put it together in a respectable manner, because you are then the other woman.
Yeah.
And there is something about, like, kind of just turning the other way and pretending it didn't happen. Mm-hmm. Or like, you know, you had said, like, you could have just kind of blocked him and forgotten
about it. Like, not my problem anymore. But that's why I respect this woman so much, because first of all, instead of her contacting him and being like, you cheated on me, she said, frick that.
Right.
I'm going to block him so he never contacts me again. I'm going directly to the wife, because she deserves to know. Yeah. And that to me just goes to show that she is a respectful woman. And she didn't know that he was married. Obviously, this would never happen. But that's why I respect it the most, because some people, even after they find out, they're like, well, like, he still wants me, he's still going to choose me. There's so many girls that do that, or women that do that all the time. Yeah. And they'll still tell the other girl, but they'll still keep that number unblocked. They'll still make sure that they're Snapchatting him, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
She cut all ties of communication and respectfully told the woman. So for that, snaps all around.
Yeah.
And I feel so sorry for the wife, or ex-wife now, I guess.
Yeah. I wonder if they had dogs. Like, I wonder if the dog part of the story was true.
I know. Because honestly,
who got the dogs?
Who got the dogs? If there really are dogs. Like, or was that just a lie?
I bet
his house is spotless. This wife seems like she's got her life together. It's probably spotless. The only reason why she couldn't come over is because there's photos of the wife and a baby.
Date me instead. That's
literally.
Okay.
Honestly, she should.
Yeah.
Wow. Well,
thank you for this juicy story.
That was pretty freaking juicy.
1 through 3 was like, oh no.
Oh no. Ah. This was the finale. We always save the best for last.
Thanks.
Always.
Thank you.
Well, Auli'i, before I let you go,
don't let me go.
Do you have any up and coming projects coming up that you want to share with the world?
This is fun. I have a movie for Hulu Disney called Darby Harper Wants You to Know. I play a cheerleader who gets electrocuted and then I die. So I play a dead cheerleader. And
zombie.
And it's very fun. I don't know when it's coming out, but Crush is out on Hulu.
Yes.
I play AJ Campos with this lovely lady beside me. And our chemistry and the chemistry of the cast is just so delightful and
it really is.
Lighthearted. And honestly, the perfect summer movie.
The perfect. It's such a feel-good, light, happy, funny movie. Like, yeah. It's not...
Yeah.
It's just a good vibes.
Yep. Watch it with your friends. Watch it with your family. Watch it during Pride Month. And most importantly, watch it outside of Pride Month.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. That is important.
Yeah. Because it's a movie for everyone of all ages. But that's it. That's me. Thank you so much.
Can you tell us a little bit about your character in the zombies? Like, are you a mean girl? Are you fun? Like, what's the... Without spoiling too much.
Yes. So I'm unfortunately not a zombie.
Oh.
I'm a dead cheerleader.
Oh.
But someone's projecting their movie role on me, and it's fine. No, it's fine. I play this girl named Capri Donahue.
Cute name.
Thank you.
It's very different.
Thank you. It was supposed to be Capri, but then I was like, it's like the pants, and I'd rather we pronounce it as Capri. And the director was like, okay. And I was like, it's short for Capricorn. And it actually made its way into the film.
Wait, that's so cute. So that's so cute.
Full name of my character is Capricorn Donahue. This is not made up. I mean, it is made up, but now it's real life.
Now it's real. Now it's made its way to the movie.
Yeah, now it's real. I got to do a whole bunch of like cheerleading things, and like I trained for that, and I like was the top of the pyramid, and they like threw me up in the air, and then they caught me, and I also did harness work where I'm in a harness because I like fly off into the afterlife. So that it was just like a very
that's so fun.
Yes, and it also filmed in South Africa.
Okay. Insane. Your photos looked so amazing when you were filming that. I was like, no way. Thank like you. South Africa, that's so
it's a very common incredible. Film spot now.
Really?
Honestly, because they don't have unions.
Oh, no way.
So overtime doesn't exist. But fantastic crews out there, gotta say, they know their stuff.
Wow.
And yeah, there are a lot of projects out there. I was very grateful to work on that movie.
Wow. Well, I'm so proud of you. You guys definitely look out for that whenever it comes out now that you know the name. And Auli'i, where can everyone follow you?
My Instagram is my name, which I will have to spell because my name is very difficult. Auli'i Cravalho, as in Victor, Alho.
Woo!
I think my Twitter is the same thing. And like, you can follow my TikTok, but I don't really post there anymore. But you might remember when I came out on TikTok. And if you don't...
Yes, I think the world remembers
if
that.
If you don't, you can just look up Auli'i Bye.
Bye? And question like, mark? And it should be the first result.
Yeah, so. it'll pop up.
Happy Pride, my friend. Look, Pride should be every month. We don't need June just for Pride. Pride is every month, period.
Amen.
Well, I love you guys so much. Thank you so much for watching. We will be back next week with another new episode. Don't forget to click the link in the description and submit your anonymous stories. We cannot wait to react to them. And don't worry, everything will be anonymous. Thank you so much, Auli'i, for being such an incredible guest. I love you so much.
Thank you.
One of my favorite people. And that's all we have for you guys.